I don't know about you guys, but I got an amazing experience out of this interview. So my interview subject is Amos Brendau, who is the co-owner of a park origin in Boulder, Colorado, called Apex Movement. And he's a very busy guy right now, so he obviously couldn't come all the way up to Maryland for me to give him or to do an interview. So luckily, I got to fly out to Colorado for a MSU trip, and while I was there, I got to visit two of the Colorado Apex gyms, and I got to interview him and one of them. And if you guys don't know what parkour is, it's a discipline of moving from one point to another in the most efficient way possible, while using only your body and the obstacles around you. And just to give you a better idea, this is a short video. So this is the Boulder Gym, and right over to the left in this, there are some couches and a coffee table, which is where the actual interview was conducted. And just a little cool fact, all of this video was shot on a Google Glass. My brother has a Google Glass. So about the interview, one of the really strong points about Amos is that he strongly values people over any kind of business investment. He told me that he doesn't consider himself to be a good businessman, because while he could have made tons and tons of decisions to help Apex as an organization grow, he felt that the people involved were more important than the investments or fancy business deals that anybody would make. And I personally was very surprised that he remembered me, because I met him in Seattle last summer, and I got to share a room with him with 5 other people, but I didn't expect him to remember me. Although, now that I think about it, we did get 4 people in a smart car driving around Seattle. So I asked him a lot about the certification of APK, Apex. That's basically training for becoming a better parkour teacher. And it is the most expensive one in the US as of now, but it is widely regarded as the best one too, because it is put together between Amos and the creator of Apex, his name is Ryan Ford. They have very different approaches. Ryan is more about the more depth with biology, while Amos is more about communication and leadership skills. And I asked him about the ups and downs of being a co-owner of a parkour gym. And he talked about how it takes the heart of the right person to do it, but it's very fulfilling. Basically, every once in a while you feel like you have your stuff on lockdown, but then all of a sudden something comes out of the blue and nails you, and then puts you under a lot of stress. But the amount of fulfillment that it gives him is definitely more than enough to keep him in the job. And some really interesting projects that Amos has been working on are Parkour Ukemi and Parkour Randori. Ukemi is the practice of falling safely without getting hurt. So, as you might think, this parkour can be very dangerous. So then you obviously need to take into account ways to fall out of something. on a 10-foot box and a lawn chair, fell backwards, and they showed him lying on the ground, pretending to be in pain. And then his other project, Brandori, is more about how some people will say, I could totally get over there in this time-sensitive situation. But nobody really has to encounter that, or not very many people encounter that. And so Brandori is all about addressing that situation, seeing what would I actually do in this situation. And it's, there's no preparation, it's all improvised. And it hasn't been worked on very much, but it's something that he's working together.